A lot of people think Excel cannot work with huge number of rows. Well, that's not true. Not only can it work with huge amount of data, but it can also fetch data from a variety of sources, which includes relational databases, websites, other Excel sheets, and much more. In fact, we will work with a huge set of data in our Power Pivot course. But do organizations really pull data from databases into Excel? Rarely. Most organizations use visualizations and reporting tools now, which allows easy customization and distribution. But Excel can fetch huge amount of data, and for simple reports and data dumps, it is still preferred by many. The most frequent options in data tab are text to columns, remove duplicates, and filter. In real projects and applications, a lot of time data is shared using delimited text files. For example, our columns in this text file are separated by pipe. If we want to open this Excel sheet, all the data will come into a single column. We can use text to column options to populate this data in the columns correctly. We click on text to column, choose delimited, then we click on next, and we specify the delimiter we have used, which for our file is pipe. And after that, the data will get substituted correctly. We will be using this often in real projects. Now that our data is aligned properly in these columns, we can go ahead and click filter. As soon as we click filter, it automatically adds this button on the top of our columns. Now we can choose to select or deselect any value that we do not want. This will be used a lot when we are doing validations. For example, we were told that this week the sales were 200 bucks. Using the filter option, we can validate if that value is correct or not. Looks like we had slightly more sales. And trust me, in real projects, you will be doing a lot of validation to ensure your data is correct. There will be situations where you may want to verify if your dataset has duplicates, or you may even want to remove them. For example, here Roger is repeating twice. The delete duplicate option will help us get rid of that. It will also give us some meaningful insights like how many rows were duplicate and how many unique rows are left. Again, this will be used often. Some of the other options that are worth mentioning are data validation. This allows us to create certain rules so that only specific kind of values can be entered in a column. For example, in this column, we can create a rule that we can have only whole numbers and the value should be between 10 and 90. So if we try to enter 100, it will throw an error and it will not allow us to do that. We will discuss this in a separate video when we discuss lists as well. Forecast sheet is another important option which allows us to forecast stuff based on historical patterns. For example, we can predict the future sales with 95% confidence that they will lie between this window. We will discuss more about it when we learn modeling and regression analysis. Excel has also introduced certain new data types, using which you can find good information about a lot of things. For example, I used to live in North Carolina. If I specify the zip code, it will give me a lot of good info about it. We can also get information about diseases. For example, if I specify COVID-19, I can check prevention, symptoms, treatment, and a lot more. We can get info about currencies, stock market, and a lot more. Do we really need to get into all this? Not really. We won't be using it often. We have already discussed sort in a previous video. And finally, we will discuss goal seek, scenario manager, and what if analysis in a separate video. So this was an overview of the data tab in the Excel ribbon.